Knowing how to style your Excel workbook is obviously necessary. Not only does styling your Excel workbook make it look more professional and presentable, it also separates different categories, numbers, and other types of data entered into your workbook. In this tutorial, we are going to teach you how to style your workbook using borders, and will then, in other tutorials, cover fills, text color, merging cells, text alignment, and number formatting. Borders in Excel. Borders are useful to separate different models, tables, and other additions that you have added to your Excel workbook. For example, if you were using Excel to build financial statements, you would become very familiar with the bottom border and the bottom double border formats. The border button can be found in the ribbon under the Home tab. As you can see, there is a drop-down menu on the Border command button. The first section of the drop-down menu is a list of the most commonly used borders. The second section is titled Draw Borders, which offers you options to draw borders by using your mouse. Finally, at the very bottom of the drop-down menu, there is an option that you can click that says More Borders. If you click on this button, the Format Cells tab dialog box will appear with the Borders tab already selected. Here you have even more options to style your borders, such as changing the line color of the border and line styles. Adding borders. The most simple way to add borders to your workbook is to select the cells to border and then select the type of border you want from the border drop-down menu. Another way to add borders in Excel is to use the Draw Borders tool. To use this method, you do not need to select the cells to be bordered because you will manually draw the borders yourself. You can either select Draw Borders from the drop-down menu or Draw Border Grid. By using the Draw Borders command, you can draw single individual borders such as bottom borders or diagonal borders. When you use the Draw Border Grid, you will add borders to all sides of the cells you draw over, including all relative cells when you move into a different row or column. Editing borders. The two most common formats you may need to change when editing borders are the line color and line style. The easiest way to make these changes is by using the line color tool and the line style tool listed under the Draw Border section of the Borders drop-down menu. For example, here we have a thick box border around the cell that contains the title. Suppose I wanted to change the border to a dark blue dotted line. All I would have to do is select my line preference from the line style command and then click on the borders I wanted to change. Then I would do the same for the line color. Erasing borders. Erasing borders is easy. If you want to remove the borders from certain cells, simply select the cells with the borders that you want to remove and then select No Borders from the drop-down menu. Using this method will remove the borders on all four sides of the cells selected. Another way to remove borders is to use the Erase Border command, which is located in the Draw Borders section of the drop-down menu. To do this, you first need to select the Erase Border command. Your cursor will turn into an eraser. With the eraser, click on the borders that you would like to remove. In this tutorial, we taught you how to use borders in Excel. Using borders along with other styling formats is fairly simple. Continue to play with the Excel features our tutorials cover, and it will only be a matter of time before you become an Excel guru yourself.